don't suppose they've got another suit back there, do you? That one looks a bit tight for me.
And you would look a right tit in it.
Evie. A letter for me.
It's a difficult world, I find. So much injustice.
There he is.
Thank you.
contribute some tea.
Thank you.
Thank you.
to wreak some havoc.
Good. You're both here. I have something to give you.
That really isn't necessary.
More gifts? You spoil me, Greenie.
Templar numbers are dwindling, and I hate to admit it, but the Rooks are thriving.
Did you hear that, Evie? Thriving.
Your time in London has been well spent. I am proud of you.
Freddy, I hardly recognized you in your police togs.
You certainly scrub up well.
I thank you for your help in collecting these bounties. I am impressed with all you have accomplished, and I wish you luck with your future endeavors.
big squeal.
My dear friend, the Ghost Club has an extraordinary case for you.
Light the lamps!
Oh. He's actually dead.
I didn't ask about this.
Nothing but a showman, really. Each week he gave a seance with all his clients present together. So many people makes everything much more dramatic. I attend Lady Ursula at these sessions. She's ailing and needs someone to help her along. I have no particular belief in an afterworld, but if it comforts my lady, I see no harm.
I sought him out after the death of Mittens. I was so hoping to hear from my loved one. I'm convinced Thaddeus could have communicated Mittens' wishes to me. I must know to whom Mittens wishes that I should leave my fortune. And now Thaddeus is lost to us. I shall never know. Mittens is my beloved kitty cat. She was run over by a milk wagon several weeks ago. I've been trying desperately to contact my sweet thing ever since. I'm not well, though, and likely haven't long to live myself.
This is so frustrating. I had a simple question, but have had to come back for seance after seance, week after week. Each time Thaddeus divined a partial number from the other side, but never the entire correct number. Today he promised that I would get everything. Thaddeus felt that if I signed some papers, it would demonstrate to my dead father that I had absolute trust in Thaddeus.
He was an incredible psychic. I came to clarify some personal financial matters. I don't understand what happened. He foretold his own death, but I didn't expect it to happen like this.
I have no doubt that his powers were genuine. He was able to tell me of my daily comings and goings, and all manner of details that he couldn't possibly have known. He certainly was going to be able to put me in contact with my sister. I'm so sorry to lose Thaddeus. The oddest part is that he claimed all would be revealed to each of us before his death. I've been coming here to decide whether I should accept a marriage proposal. Thaddeus had been attempting to contact my departed sister so that she could give me advice. Thaddeus was a kind man who sincerely wanted me to make the best choice. Now what am I to do?
My brother has become obsessed with some secret bank account. He inherited almost all of my father's fortune, as well he should as the male heir, but some was locked in a secret account. I think it unlikely that it should be a significant amount. I went along to the seances a couple of times. I thought it was a waste of my brother's time. Power of attorney to a psychic? That sounds very unusual indeed.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
Her father mentioned this swindler to me. I understand it's because of him that my engagement has been delayed. I know the owner of local brewery, and I'm convinced his business will flourish. He just needs some financial backing. Now Janice is free to be married at last. I'll invest my dowry in the brewery and make a fortune.
Never trust a man who tells you what you want to hear. He's after something. Taking advantage of my daughter's love for her departed sister. With that charlatan gone, things can get back to normal. My daughter's engagement to Everett Boyd can be announced at last. Janice's eldest sister was strong-willed. Janice always followed her lead. That's why it's so sad that she asks her advice, even in death. Time for Janice to think for herself. I know what's best for her. A girl of Janice's age should be married. Everett is a very sensible young man from a good family. He'll be very successful, I'm sure of it. Janice is a lovely creature. I would be honored were she to accept my proposal. I do adore her.
Lady Ursula's health is not good at all. And now she's lost her cat, it's almost like she has nothing left to live for. He's been Lady Ursula's butler for years. We have plans to marry. But first, Douglas needs to put together a little nest egg. He says he'll have some money soon. Lady Ursula was planning to leave her fortune to her cat Mittens. Since the cat passed on, she's been going to that spiritualist in hopes that Mittens will tell her what to do with the money.
Thank you.
I attend Lady Ursula at these sessions. She's ailing and needs someone to help her along. I have no particular belief in an afterworld, but if it comforts Milady, I see no harm. Nothing but a showman, really. Each week he gave a seance with all his clients present together. So many people makes everything much more dramatic.
That's me. Yeah, some fella come by here every so often. Gives me a silver sixpence if I tell him everything about the folks in that house. Nothing unusual about him. Just a regular fella. I seen him go into that building over there.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
Yeah.
You believe that Everett paid Thaddeus to manipulate me? It cannot be true. Thaddeus knew all of my comings and goings. He genuinely could communicate with the world beyond.
Good Lord, you found the office? I admit it then. Thaddeus and I traveled the world, bamboozling the gullible and exposing the swindle. But his death was meant to be a fake. I have no reason to want Thaddeus dead. Quite the contrary.
My own sister, paying Thaddeus off? I thought he was a bit too insistent that I sign that paper. Well, Anne is going to get a good talking to, believe you me.
I simply do not believe it. And if you're implying that my butler was paying Thaddeus, I must ask you, why would a great psychic do the bidding of a common butler?
You think someone paid Thaddeus to tell my lady that a cat wanted them to inherit? Well, that would be quite a clever scheme indeed.
He was going to reveal my plot. He paid the price for betraying a fellow crook.
This Thaddeus fellow was rather too clever by half. But you pieced it all together very cleverly.
Up to the click with you.
Mr. Rayner was particularly interested in this one. He admired the duplicity of Thaddeus.
Hey! Someone help! Some trap found something down there! Looks like foul play!
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions. I should go back and ask about this.
I heard a splash, and right quick pulled this bloke out of the shallows, dead as a mackerel. I live there now. If you can call it living. I lost my job, didn't I? No need for the likes of me when a machine can do the work. The midnight train, that must be the 616, stops in the station down the road. If you hurry, it might still be there. A nice warm coat like that on a dead man? What do you expect? I snatched it before somebody else came along to nick it. Like you.
Better hurry. It's leaving right now.
I should go back and ask about this.
Nothing unusual at all. I had a drink with some gents and then retired to my sleeper. The rich fella, I did talk with him. Very charming. But a single woman has to be careful, you know? Did something happen to him? Oh, all right. I flirt with rich blokes and the barman slips him a mickey. I take him back to my sleeper and they nod off before I have to do anything shameful. They wake up thinking they had a night of fun and hand me a few quid. That's what happened with Mr. Killian, but he was gone when I come back from looking for the man who left the note.
Mr. Wolf had a few with Mr. Killian. Then the young lady invited herself over to have a glass with him. Mr. Wolf became terribly tired, even though he'd only had one drink. He toddled off to bed well before midnight. I stayed in the dining car for a few drinks with the barman. Mr. Wolf bought him drink after drink. Then they got angry. But the young lady came over and it's obvious that Mr. Killian was interested in a rendezvous, like. Around about 11:30, Killian and her left together.
I had drinks in the dining car with Killian. We had business dealings in the past. It was a pleasant surprise to discover him on this train. I suppose there were some disagreements, but there always are when a great deal of money is involved. Sam, he's a trusted valet. He's terrifically strong, which makes him useful in many situations. You mean the young lady? She and Killian hit it off famously. Embarrassing, really. I felt unusually tired and came back here to get some sleep.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
Someone slipped a note under my sleeper door a few minutes before midnight. It said I should come to the dining car. I went, but only Ryan and Wolf's man were there, and they were both drunk.
Valet for going on several years. He's frail and needs a man like me to help him about.
Boys, Some noises on the roof woke me up briefly. You say someone was thrown from up there. You have to be a very strong fella to drag someone up onto the roof. That one. Clever little minx. She and the bombman got a little scam going. I think everyone on the staff knows about it. Killian was on this train. Cool. I used to work at his foundry. I never even seen him. None of us workers ever knew what he looked like. Vivian had another of her dupes in her compartment by then. After that, I remember people going past me from time to time, but I was half asleep.
Nothing unusual. A couple of passengers came in and had a sort of business meeting. One of them was buying a lot of drinks for the other, and then they started to argue. But Vivian went over and joshed them out of it. She's a frequent passenger, that one. Hangs about with the wealthier sort. Likes to entertain them, if you take my meaning. Yeah, I helped Vivian fleece the dupes. I slipped a pill in the wine for the table. Both gents got sleepy, but Vivian picked the richest one.
It was a typical evening. As far as I knew, nothing unusual happened until you came aboard with this story of a murder. Just another wealthy passenger. They're all pretty much the same. I was tidying up in the passenger car. Around midnight, Vivian ran through. She thought someone was looking for her. She rides the train often. She's very friendly with the other passengers.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
Well, it's a noisy train. Plenty of passengers have trouble getting to sleep, so I keep a sedative here behind the bar, yeah? Peter, nice bloke. Came here after being sacked from a foundry a few months ago. I tell you, he looked white as a ghost after he served the businessman.
Gave him what he deserved. The man was heartless.
I believe something larger is afoot. A lot of murderous anger concerning industrialists. Might be something to look into.
Up to the clink with you!
Good, you're here. This isn't the first time His Highness has had troubles with the British Indies Company. Yeah. A couple of years ago, they held his mother captive and blocked all his letters to her. Yeah. Odds are they're keeping his correspondence from reaching the outside world once again. I have acquired the mail courier schedule. Yeah. There are two separate routes of transport. The first, a mail carrying carriage convoy. The second, a train.
Let's go.
If we set up an ambush, you should be able to see his letters. Maybe this will change his mind. Start with the convoy. We must block the road. The mail convoy will be here any minute now. Scout the area for allies. I will guard the area.
you. You're with me.
We've got dynamite planted near the convoy's ambush location.
Aye, aye.
To my side.
Convoy is headed our way.
Rooks, you're with Henry.
Understood.
Will do.
Got it.
Two? I said I was thinking about it.
The convoy is headed our way.
Rooks, you're with Henry.
Understood.
Will do.
Spare a penny for me and my boy.
Don't be afraid to spill a little blood.
Right? It's one of those bloody rooks.
Got them.
Repeat the same process with the train. I must return to my shop and shall invite Mr. Singh over for a spot of tea.
You are no lost to humanity.
This one won't be needing breakfast tomorrow. You never know.
That's a girl. Stay put.
All right then.
Any moment, we need reinforcements.
Rook, to me. You, your heart.
The letters are on that train.
Train's coming.
Got it.
Will do.
This time!
Here we are. Now back to Greeny.
There is a difference between pacifism and inaction.
How many times do I have to tell you?
You two do have impeccable timing.
Can we interrupt something?
I believe these will be of interest to you, Your Highness.
These letters, they are from me. The seals have been broken.
That's how we found them.
This is a letter I wrote to my mother when I was just a boy. Where did you find these possessions of mine?
On a mail convoy.
The Templars. They have a way of getting to you.
I thought I had put an end to it years ago, but the British Indies Company continues to steal my property. You were right to think something strange was afoot.
We must take action, but it will not be possible without your help.
I believe you're right, but I must have some time to think on this. In the meantime, please be discreet. I don't need Her Majesty finding out about this.
This way, my dear. I've something to show you. Hop in.
Where are we going?
One of Sterling's workshops, where they build weapons for his army. When the world is full of nasty things, we must tear those things apart. Man like Starek built a world around his own desire.
That's the way. In you.
You must see the potential, dear Jacob. This workshop is one of Starek's. Set the dynamite and let's blow it to atoms. Together.
That's one. something's lurking.
Set.
Once I've finished with you, they'll never find your body. Nothing's gonna slip past me.
And done. All rigged up.
Perfect! Let's put our plan into action. Stand back! Ready!
Wait!
Whatever for?
There are children in there.
Jacob, my dear. Starek uses child labor to manufacture goods. We must put an end to his production line.
But not like this.
Why not? I can do whatever I damn well please! Soon, you will understand what it is to be free, as I am. Light them up, boys!
No!
What the hell are you doing?
We're not playing games anymore, Roth!
No, we're not.
Gift, sir, from Mr. Roth. You should be warned, Mr. Fry, that when Roth is angry with one, he generally brings suffering to many.
My dearest Jacob, alas, it seems our adventures together have come to a close. Although our time together was brief, it's left a lasting mark. I wish you well
in all your future endeavors. Cordially, Maxwell. Postscriptum. I'm putting on a show this evening. All of London will be there. Enclosed, please find your invitation. Monsieur, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Alhambra Music Hall. Tonight, we have For one night only, a very special performance of Corvus the Trickster. While some of the effects may be visceral and highly disturbing, do not be alarmed, my good people. Fear not. This is a purest form of entertainment. Tonight's performance immortalizes and is for the benefit of a young fellow very near and dear to my heart. Any concerns or complaints may be addressed to him. Jacob, dear boy, tonight is for you.
I'll be serving you this evening, gentlemen.
You're still here, love. Last time, I swear, you nearly poisoned us.
Scene two, stand by!
Let me out! I need to lower the grip for the show!
Two porters and a ginger ale, if you please.
We have a volunteer! A big round of applause for this brave, brave man! Our volunteer is about to die for you, Jacob.
What a brave soul going up on stage like that.
You lucky people are about to witness this gentleman being fired upon at point-blank range. Our performer will hit several targets placed around his head.
If he's not Roth.
Exciting, is it not? Will our honored guest go unharmed? We British are a hardy bunch. Let's put that hardiness to the test.
Thank you.
not a frill. Do not fret, my friends. It's all part of the show. Please stay with us as we prepare for the next turn. Oh my, are your principles drifting, dear?
That's a daisy. Tom, watch them.
We found a suitably flat-headed gentleman for this one. You laugh, ladies and gentlemen, but I assure you that is the case. I have no doubt that you could hazard a guess as to what this one concerns, my friend. Courageous participant hasn't even flinched.
Come out. I won't hurt ya.
Standing a few feet away, our performer expertly throws his knife at the apple, slicing it in two. Will he or won't he?
Excuse me, love. Just looking for the lavatory.
It's over there.
Thanks.
Well done!
not my husband.
Lucky I'm trying to keep out of trouble.
I never feel like it.
The flavor intensified the second time. The hunt, now a search for want rather than need. For this trick, ladies and gentlemen, we have found a most courageous volunteer. With our courageous volunteer in the box, the celebrated illusionist will proceed to saw him in half. Watch as our esteemed guest emerges unharmed. Our skilled illusionist, Sabretooth Jane, is performing this famous trick. She is said to have studied at the feet of the mysterious Torini himself. The saw Miss Jane is using this evening is imported from the ancient city of Codumenum, celebrated for manufacturing the finest steel in the world. Behold the grace with which Jane wields her saw. A diamond in the rough, I dare say. Marvelous. To thank our guest for participating in the show, we've invited him backstage to partake of some refreshment before returning to the audience. Our next turn will begin shortly. Please stay seated as we prepare. You won't want to miss this. Are you trying to repent, my dear? It is not too late to join me in my grand finale.
Where is he?
Roth!
The search consumes. Pray visualized, mouth watering.
I hope you have enjoyed your evening so far, ladies and gentlemen. I know I have. Now, before our final act, I would like to toast all you brave people who joined us tonight to celebrate life and death. Go on! Toast them! Your move, Jacob, my dear! Burn! 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 Jacob, my dear, where are you? Join me for the finale. Over here, Jacob.
What a ghastly smell!
Don't hide from me, darling.
We'll be right back.
Darling, what a night. The stuff of legends.
Why did you do it? All of it.
What? Snap a baby crow's neck between my thumb and forefinger. Slice to bits the ones you deem innocent. Keep the world in its divine manic state. For the same reason I do anything. Why not?
Get out alive. I'll never make it out alive. Damn this place from hell to Hackney. Nightmare. I'll never make it out alive. Damn this place from hell to Hackney.
Ah!
damn this place from hell to Hackney.
Thank you.